Good afternoon, everybody. Today I am going to tell you the question and answers of 10th standard first language English topic, The Gift of Magi. Answer briefly the following questions. Question number 1. How did Della save her $1.87? Answer. Della had saved the money by bargaining hard about prices with the grocer, the vegetable man and the butcher. Question 2. The writer gives details of Jim's flat. Pick out the details. Answer. It was a furnished flat at $8 per week. There was nothing to describe. In the vestibule below was a letter box into which no letter would go and an electric button from which mortal finger could coax a ring. Attached to the button was a card bearing the name James Dillingham Young. Question 3. The card bearing the full name of Jim now had only one letter D on it. State whether the statement is true or false. Answer. The above statement is true. Question 4. What were the most precious possession of Jim and Della? Answer. The most precious possession of Jim was the gold watch that had been his father's and his grandfather's before him. Della's possession was her long, rippling, shining hair that fell down like a cascade of brown waters. Question 5. How has the writer compared Della's hair to Queen of Sheba's jewels? Answer. The writer says that had the Queen of Sheba lived in the flat across the air shaft, Della would have let her hair hang out the window some day to dry just to depreciate Her Majesty's jewels and gifts. Question 6. How has the writer compared Jim's watch to King Solomon's treasures? Answer. The writer says that had King Solomon been the geniator with all his treasures piled up the basement, Jim would have pulled out his watch every time he passed just to see and pluck at his beard with envy. Question 7. Why did Della decide to sell her hair? Answer. Della wanted to buy a gift for Jim and she had only $1.87, which was not sufficient to buy any gift. Hence, she decided to sell her hair and buy a good gift with the money she would get. Question 8. How much money did she get for her hair? Answer. She got $20 for her hair. Question 9. What did Della buy for Jim? Answer. Della bought a platinum fob chain to be used for Jim's watch in place of the old leather strap that he used. Question 10. How was the gift worthy of the watch? Answer. The platinum fob chain was simple and chaste in design, properly proclaiming its value by substance alone and not by mere precious ornament. Question 11. The writer says that platinum chain was like Jim. How? Answer. Della feels that the platinum chain was like Jim, quietness and valuable. The description applied to both. Question 12. What did Della try to fix before Jim get home? Answer. Della tried to fix her chopped hair with curls before Jim got home. Question 13. What was Jim's reaction when he saw Della without her lovely hair? Answer: Jim was dumbstruck upon seeing Della. His eyes were fixed upon Della, and there was an expression in them that she could not read. Question 14. What was Jim's gift for Della? Give a brief description of the gift. Answer: Jim's gift for Della was a set of combs, side and back, that Della had worshipped long in a Broadway window. They were beautiful, expensive combs made of pure tortoise shells with jeweled rims, just the shade to wear in the beautiful brown hair of Della. Question 15. Were the gifts useful to each other? Answer: No, the gifts were not useful to either of them. Question 16. How did Della react when she saw Jim's gift to her? Answer: There was an ecstatic scream of joy when Della saw Jim's gift to her. Then immediately there was a quick change to hysterical tears and wails. She recalled how much she had yearned for them. She hugged them to her bosom and at length looked up with dim eyes and a smile and assured Jim that her hair would grow very fast. Question 17. Jim and Della both gave up something dear to them. What does it tell us about them? Answer: We have been already told that Jim and Della are a loving couple. Even in their exigent condition, they desire to gift something to each other. Both keep their attempts to buy a gift a secret from each other in order to gather the money needed to buy a gift. They sell the most precious things they possess. Though their gifts prove to be useless, they gain in love and satisfaction with each other. Question 18. O. Henry's stories often blend humor and pathos. The description of the card bearing Jim's name is an example of this. Can you identify one more example from the story? Answer: The mention of a pyroglass between the windows of the room is one more example of O. Henry's humor blended with pathos. A very thin and very agile person might, by observing his reflection in a rapid sequence of longitudinal strips, obtain a fairly accurate conception of his looks. Della, being slender, had mastered this art. The other example is of Della's gift. When Jim looks at Della's gift, he just puts his hands under the back of his head and smiles. He tells Della to put away their Christmas presents for some time, as they were too nice to use just at that time. Question 19. Who were the Magi? Answer: The Magi were the wise men who brought gifts to the newborn Jesus. According to the Bible, the Magi were three kings, Caspar, Melchior, and Balthasar, who traveled to Bethlehem from somewhere in East, probably Persia. Question 20. What is the writer's last word to the wise of these days? Answer: The writer says that these two, that is, Della and Jim, were the wisest of all those who give gifts. Of all who give and received gifts, they were the wisest. They were the Magi.